Open the previously used Office Building 2 PLN file from the Startup folder. Notice we receive a warning message while opening the project file. Some hotlinks in the projects are outdated. Select Update to use the latest version of the modules. After the project opens, the changes we made to the module file are clearly visible on the floor plan view. The real advantage of this technology is that you can create multiple instances of even very complex modules with just one click. Furthermore, any changes in the source module files are instantly updated in all placed instances. Let's complete the stairway now and place the previously created module on all stories. Now let's select any element of the module. All module elements are selected at once. Choose the Edit, Copy command from the menu. Go to the next floor by double-clicking its name in the project map of the navigator. Activate the Edit, Paste command to paste the elements. Repeat the same sequence on all floors up to the 20th story. You may use the corresponding paste shortcut to paste the elements. Check the results in 3D. Double-click the fifth story in the Navigator project map to open its floor plan view. We are going to join the central part of the building with the two towers. In order to join the spaces of the module and the tower, we have to remove some parts of the wall. We will use the Split command. This command basically shortens the existing element and creates a new one on the other side of the splitting plane. This will also have an effect on the curtain wall connections because the newly created wall will not have any automatic connections, while the existing wall will no longer need both side connections. In order to split the wall, we will first remove the connection between the curtain wall and the wall at one side. If we split the wall, just one part of the wall will inherit the original properties. Activate View. On-screen View Options. Walls and Beams Reference Lines command. The direction of the wall's reference lines will be seen on the floor plan view. On the right side of the left tower, the direction of the reference line is upwards. This means that the bottom part of the wall will inherit the connection with the curtain wall when cut. Thus, we are going to remove the connection with the upper curtain wall. Select the vertical wall on the left of the screen. Notice that the connection icon is displayed. Hover the mouse of the connection icon to highlight the connected elements, in our case, the two curtain walls. Click the connection icon to review these connections. It's important to keep track of which elements are connected to which. Hover the mouse over the connections to highlight the connected curtain wall elements. Highlight the connection that corresponds to the curtain wall at the top and click the X sign to delete this connection. Notice the change in the floor plan. Please click the upper end point of the reference line and move the cursor upwards while holding down the Shift key to slightly elongate this reference line as presented on the screen. Choose the Split icon from the toolbar. Zoom into the lower part of the selected wall. Let's define the split line by clicking on the internal side of the connecting horizontal wall when the cursor changes to the Mercedes sign. Afterward, click upwards with the eye cursor. Resize the upper part of the wall. Adjust the reference line to the upper horizontal wall segment. Make sure that the reference lines of the two walls meet. Move the cursor to the bottom edge of the horizontal wall at the top. We need to reconnect this wall segment with the curtain wall. Select both elements, and then right-click on an empty area to display the context menu. Select Connect, Join Walls to Curtain Wall command from the context menu. Click Join in the upcoming dialog to proceed. Notice that the wall is reconnected with the curtain wall. The bottom part of the wall and the bottom curtain wall are still connected to each other. Zoom out to overview the changes. Repeat the same sequence with the wall of the other tower. Please be careful. The direction of the other wall's reference line is the opposite of what it was before. Select the other vertical wall and click on the connection icon. Hover the mouse over the available connections and delete the connection with curtain wall in the bottom of the screen. Elongate the reference line of the wall to help further editing. Activate the split command. And split the vertical wall at the top horizontal wall. Adjust the length of the vertical wall. Select the lower vertical wall segment and the curtain wall. Select Connect, Join Walls to Curtain Wall command from the context menu to reconnect these elements. Click Join in the upcoming dialog to proceed. Zoom out to view the results. Switch off the visibility of the reference lines by using the View, On-screen View options, Walls and Beams Reference Lines menu option. Open the 3D view to check out the project in 3D. Switch back to the floor plan view and save the project by activating the Save command from the File menu. We will continue this lesson by working on the previously saved Hotlinked module file.